Dreamhouse Biodigesters, thank you so much for joining us on this channel where we do videos that give homeowners that needed peace of mind in terms of their toilet wastewater management issue. We also do videos for those who are interested in learning how to construct a biodigester. The biodigester course is very, very comprehensive, designed for those interested in learning how to construct a biodigester. The link is in the description below. Now, this video is about comparing septic tanks to biodigesters. I've done several videos, over 30 videos, that has talked about how biodigesters work and how they are giving homeowners that needed peace of mind. So in this particular video, I'm going to be fair, I'm going to be open, I'm going to explain to you what biodigesters are, one. I'm also going to tell you about septic tanks as an alternative means of toilet wastewater management. I'm going to open it up and then give you the advantages of either one of them. So if you're new to this channel, subscribe for videos about biodigesters and about home improvement in general. Now, I was at a site recently to do an inspection for a property whose owner wanted to do additional biodigesters for the summer huts that they have constructed. And I saw this huge septic tank, arguably the biggest septic tank I have seen in my life. I've not been to a lot of places, but this is a huge septic tank, 5 chambers, solid one, about 20 feet depth, 5 chambers, and the blocks have been laid flat on top of each other, not like the normal way of block laying. So you can imagine the amount of blocks and concrete works and stuff that has gone into it. And I can tell you two things from this. If you are able to do a tank like this, you will not have to be bothered about dislodging ever again. But then the other question will be, at what cost, right? Okay. A septic tank basically works in such a way that you have to have chambers done. So it can be 3 chambers. Ideally, what I've known over the years is that the best chambers that work for septic tanks are the 3 chambers, where there's the first chamber, and then there's the second chamber, and then there's the third chamber. So there's an overflow tank to a level whereby after the solid settles down, you can have the water going into the next chamber, and then it can also settle down, and then it can go into the third chamber. Then there's a soak away where the wastewater can be floated slowly into the earth surface. But what happens is, because the bottom of the septic tank is sealed most of the time, the human waste will have to settle. If you're lucky and the water goes into the soak away and then the ground is good enough, then it's able to soak the water, then obviously it will last you a longer time. Then you don't have to worry, because then human waste or the solubles will settle down, and then it can break down slowly, and then it can become like sand at the base of it. Some people have used septic tanks over the years and they've not had any problem. But mostly depending on the area in which the property is located and the type of soil that they meet when the septic tank is done. On the other hand, if you are not able to get the wastewater or the water to be soaked into the ground, then it means that you will need a truck to come and help you dislodge it periodically. The problem I've realized over the years is that most people have a shorter timeline for the dislodging, and that's what becomes the problem for them. Because if you have to dislodge every 3 months or every 6 months, and the cost that you are going to incur in dislodging is 500 or 600 cedis, considering how long you're going to live in that house and the number of people who are going to be using it, and then how many times you have to dislodge in a year, all will go to affect your budget. So those are the considerations that most people will make. And because of the amount of work involved in constructing a septic tank, it might take you like 1 week, some take 2 weeks, some take 3 weeks. Because when you do the concrete at the base, you are required to leave it for it to dry enough before the blocks are laid on it. And then you need your iron rods for the top cover to cast it so that it can become firm and then it might not sink in. So the space required for a septic tank is key. The kind of space that you need for a septic tank is key. And the installation time, The number of weeks or days it might take you to have it constructed will also come in place. Now, when you do construct the septic tank, you also need to make sure that the space or the depth is important when it comes to septic tanks. Septic tanks works in such a way that the water and the human waste are going to stay together in the same place, which means that the deeper, the better. If you have enough feet going down, is dug well, if they're able to dig 20 feet or 15 feet and they do not meet water, then the better for you. It means that it will take you a long time for two things to happen. Either the human waste likely will settle down slowly for you, and then the soak away will work well, whereby it will not come to the top for you to get full, and that will require you needing a truck to come and dislodge. And the second thing is, the longer the human waste stays in the septic tank, the better it's able to break down to a level whereby it can settle at the base, and then the water can go into the overflow tank, and then it can go into the soak away for disposal, for the soak away to do its part of the work. So that's the one of the key things when it comes to septic tanks, that in case you are going to construct a septic tank, you are supposed to look out for. You are also supposed to take into account the environment that is being done. It also means that the more sandy the soil is, the better it is for you. If it's a clay area, well, it's not bad, but if it's a waterlogged area, it means that it's possible for leakage to happen. Another good thing about septic tank is that if it's constructed well, all the pipes that are coming from the house, whenever you have to lay them, will not be a problem. Because if the septic tank is 15 feet or 20 feet deep, or let's say 10 feet, and the pipes that the plumber is laying from the house is coming into the septic tank, will come and fall, let's say at the base, at 3 feet or 2 feet or 4 feet even, it's not a problem for you, because then you can do your pavement in the house and then those pipes can be buried, because most people do not like their pipes showing when they construct their, when they are doing the compound. They prefer the pipes all to be buried underground. And septic tank works in this situation well, because then the pipes can always be buried. The type of seeds that you're going to use is also not a problem. You can decide to use your P-trap or you can use your S-trap, because then the pipe can be buried, and then even if it's taking up to 4 feet to go into the septic tank, it's not going to be a problem, because there's enough chamber or enough space at the base for the human waste to come and for the water itself to come to a level before you might require dislodging. If your soak away is working well, then it means that you do not have a problem when you do construct a septic tank. In contrast to biodigesters, because the depth of the digester is not deep, when you intend on constructing a biodigester, you have two options. Either the footing of the building is up enough, and then the pipe that is coming into the digester has got a very good gentle slope or gentle gradient, then it can come and fall in at the top part of the digester. So let's say it's a 3-bedroom house and you intend on constructing a biodigester. The depth of the digester is basically 3 feet. So the pipe that is coming from the house will have to come at an angle and in such a way that you would then not require it falling at the base of the digester, which you then will render it ineffective. So then that's why sometimes we recommend people use P-trap when they're going to do a biodigester, and if their area or the location is not ground that can soak the water. In terms of their installation, in terms of installing or construction of biodigesters, it can be done in a day if you are using precast or prefabricated slabs for the construction. It can be done in less than 5 hours. If you are using blocks, you have to consider 2 days maximum, because it means that you have to do the top slab and wait for it to dry and then lay the blocks, and then you can do the inside bedding before covering it up. But if you compare it to a septic tank, you have to do the concrete works, you have to lay the blocks, and then you have to cast the top slab as well, because most of the time the location of the septic tank will require you having a cast concrete done on it, so that the car can walk on it or other things can also be done on it, because probably it's also requiring a lot of space on your compound or in the house. you will need that space also to do other things. And that's why when you're doing a septic tank, it might take you sometimes 2 weeks, sometimes take 3 weeks for it to be done. With biodigesters, you are not in that space, you are not in that time frame, and you are not on that timeline, because when the space required, the depth is also not deep, and then the materials required are not that much. So that's another comparison of septic tanks to biodigesters. The size of a biodigester compared to septic tank is very, very negligible. It's small. Then so people also ask sometimes, this small size thing that I'm seeing, how is it going to help me and my family, and is going to do the job or what you guys said it will do? One of the key reasons is that when it comes to digesters, the separation, you know, with septic tanks, the soak away is attached to the tank itself, or the soak away is virtually non-existent, because then the human waste and the water are all together in the tank. And then the hope and prayer is that the human waste will settle down, and then the water can overflow into the next chamber, and then subsequently into a soak away if there's one, or into an overflow tank, right? So with biodigesters, the difference is that there's going to be a rapid separation of the waste from the digester immediately you flush, so that the water goes into the soak hole or goes into a whatever option that you have there, and then the human waste is what stays in the digester for the microorganism to feed on it. Another comparison of the septic tank to the biodigester is the amount of money required in their construction and the time it takes for them to be constructed. Obviously, because of the size of the septic tank, it will require you a longer time to have it constructed, and the materials that you might need for the septic tank will be higher. So let's say you are doing a septic tank, a 10 by 10 septic tank, you might require about 300 blocks, and then you might need your iron rod, you might need the concrete to be done at the base, you might need the plastering, and the number of cement that will be required will also be there. So all those things will go into determining the cost for you when it comes to septic tank. On the other hand, when it comes to a biodigester, and you need a standard biodigester for a family of, let's say, 4 or 3, you need about 50 blocks, you need a 3/8 mm cutter rod, 6 of them for your top slab, you need about 3 or 4 cement, and then you need the inside materials that will help, and of course you need the soak away to be done, or the soak hole to be done, and then a few blocks or stones that will have to go into it to help with the water filtration. So if you are deciding to choose what type of wastewater management you will need for your house, and you are going to decide between a septic tank and a biodigester, you will have to consider the cost that's also involved. You will also have to consider the space that is required when it comes to either one of these. The septic tank will require you a bigger space, and then the digester will obviously require a small space. It can go at the back of the building and it can be hidden there. The other difference is that the septic tank can be done in front of the house, but then the car can park on it, and then it can be done firmly, and then it can be placed that you will not have a problem whenever it's time for you to dislodge. In comparing this digester, we usually prefer the digester is located in such a place that you do not let cars park on it. If you intend to do a digester for a car to park on it, then it means that you have to do reinforcement, you have to do a lot of concrete works. But then when it comes to the time for you to do maintenance, then it means that all those concretes will have to be broken down. But then from experience, most of the time it's best to do the digester because of the space that's required, and just at the back or at a nice place where you do not need a car to work on it. So that's one of the considerations that you have to make when you are also considering one of these technology. The other one is the smell or the scent that generated from either one of these technology. I have used both of them, I've constructed both of them before, and I'm sure you are also aware the septic tank will breed odor, will breed smell, especially when it's time for the truck to come and have the human waste dislodged from the house. It's mainly because the human waste, together with the water and the bacteria that are in it, that generate the maggots and all those bad bacteria with to smell that aid in the decomposition, are not doing the work well. So that's why the human waste smells when you have a a septic tank and it's time to have it dislodged, and then you see the flies around sometimes as well. With the biodigester, it's fly free, it's also odorless. I've told some people it's odorless and they don't believe me. It's a simple reason, because let's say the moment you separate the human waste from the water, what is left is basically something that will break down. So obviously it will not attract flies and it will not also smell. That's one side of the digester where it is odorless, is fly free. The reason why the biodigesters became very big in Ghana was because of how safe they are for the environment. And it's also because then we have been using the septic tank over the years, and the mode and the method of the treatment of the sludge and the solid waste has become a problem for us. Most of the time, over the years in Accra especially, there was a place, there's a famous place we are calling the Lavender Hill, where if you go there, you see the tanks are bringing the sludge and the solid waste for treatment. And then it's not treated enough, and then it's being dumped into the sea, because then that's the only option that we have in terms of the treatment. But with the biodigesters, the idea is that you can treat it at your backyard. It's also known as a simple on-site wastewater management treatment system, which means that the solid waste is treated at your backyard. When it's time for you to dislodge or to do maintenance or remove the remains in it, then it can be taken out, because there's virtually nothing in it. Ground can be dug and can be put at the backyard of your house. With digesters, you do not need a truck to dislodge. With septic tanks, you require a truck dislodging, whereby the solid waste is carried away to be treated at a plant or at a site. So if you are considering any of these two, these are a few of the comparisons that you can look at, and then the one that you think will serve you best is what you are supposed to look at. The space required is one. The dislodging, in terms of the cost, if you have to have maintenance or dislodging done, is two. And then the amount of money required to have either one of them constructed is three. The environmental safety and how conducive are they to the environment is four. And then the quick, in terms of the timelines for its construction, is also five. You are also looking at whether the smell or the environment, how safe they are for the environment, and all these things must be compared when you are looking at biodigester as well as a septic tank. Watching the next video showing up on your screen will give you a fair idea about how biodigesters is and how they work and why probably they are your best bet when it comes to toilet wastewater management here in Ghana.